It's really hard to start with, and it's that fear of the blank paper, and it's just the same in terms of the blank screen and where do I start, and particularly because we were involving students and thinking about what students might like to read from my blog and what I was almost willing to let them know about as well, sort of giving over that little bit of power almost.
As it progressed, what was really interesting, and for me a bit of a revelation, was that not only did it enable me to comment on their learning, which they were reflecting on in their blogs, but they were commenting on my learning. And I thought that was really very powerful.
I started off in September, avidly reading, in fact. I couldn't stop. I was absolutely fascinated by the blogs that the students were writing. And I would find myself quite late at night sitting at home reading blogs and putting comments up, and absolutely amazed by the energy and the excitement that was coming out in these blogs.
One of the things they said was it helped them to get to know who we were and to know us and to see where we were coming from and to feel a bit more comfortable with us, so that they could come and talk to us in the corridor much more easily.
I was surprised at how much I enjoyed it. There's something in me that likes reflecting on my own learning and just bits of my life and putting them out there for people to read. And it's a real buzz when somebody replies. Somebody comments, you think, oh, there is somebody out there who's actually quite interested in bits of my life.
I think I missed a trick a bit, because I think although I encourage the students to blog, I'm going to perhaps put more effort into encouraging them to comment on each other's blogs. And therefore I'll be strengthening the bonds between them. So I'm going to be doing that. And little things I think would help in that way would be things like making sure that they had a photograph of themselves on their blogging site so that other students recognised who they were.
Well, I read the blogs of our students, and I found that really important because you got a sense of where they are, what they were interested in, also what they were taking from sessions, which sometimes wasn't what you thought, you know, you were doing in the session.
Sometimes they're a little bit formal, and they're sometimes used as more of a recording of an assignment or research, but actually in some ways it's more effective for it to be an actual learning journey, because it encourages other students to read it and comment on it if it's an actual learning journey, and they're talking about how they relate to what they're actually writing about a little bit more, so sort of taking it from being what can sometimes be a little bit sterile into more meaningful, so you can get a better interaction going on.
I would like with these first year students for it to continue, and one of the ways of doing that, and to widen out and to broaden them, one of the ways might be, and I'd like to suggest this, is that the group who will be moving into the second year became mentors for the first year, because traditionally we've had very little link between the year groups.
I found the sense of audience a bit difficult, so I've had to rethink that, and I want to start again blogging and choose something particular about my role that I want to explore and let other people share in the exploration and start again. But it made me realise that it could be tricky for students, because who are they writing to?
I've also become much more aware of the kind of ethics of blogging. I realise now that we actually asked the students to do something that was very scary. We asked them to go online and to write something that would be read by every single person who's involved in the university. And I think now I should have perhaps given a bit of a health warning.
These blogs are very open, and students need to think about that really carefully, and to think more particularly perhaps about the purpose of why we're using the blogs. Are we using it for personal reflection? Are we using it for social interaction? And can we think of some really exciting ways that we can encourage them all to join in and all to interact, and really see it as a really useful starting point on their learning community and their first year at the university?